Coming up on Wax News, we'll be learning about a fifth grade student that stood out to his teachers due to his advanced computer programming skills.
We'll also get the inside scoop about the current class fundraisers and a recap of the exciting badminton tournament. We were also able to get a behind-the-scenes look at the upcoming Vitality Fashion Show. All that and more, be sure to stick with us.
It's a rare condition this day and age to read any good news on the newspaper page. And love and tradition of the grand design, some people say, is even harder to find. Well, then there must be some magic clue inside these gentle walls, 'cause all I see is a tower of dreams, real love bursting out of every scene.
And I'm Carly Hopshaw. Welcome to Wax News.
One of our headlining stories today is part of a new segment we're starting called Exceptional Students. Each week, I will showcase a hardworking and dedicated student from our very own school district. This week, our exceptional student was a fifth grader in Mr. Dindell's class named Hayden. Hayden is an exceptional student because he has developed computer programming skills at a very young age. Hayden's interest in advanced programming was recognized by a student on the high school's robotics team. Last year, the team came to the middle school to show the students their newest build. Hayden understood everything they were saying and asked many questions. Later on, Hayden was able to display his skills during a Big Brother Big Sister club meeting. Recently, Hayden has been working on a project with robotics coach Mr. Turk.
Hayden certainly wowed us all here at Wax News. His ability to develop and understand such complex skills at a young age is remarkable. Keep up the good work, Hayden. As February comes to a close, Wax News would like to highlight the importance of Black History Month. Even though the practice of honoring Black history dates back to the 1920s, Black History Month was only made an official celebration 34 years ago. There was a time in history when African Americans were portrayed in history books as inferior beings. They were often viewed as only in a negative light. Now, Black History Month is an annual celebration of the achievements by African Americans in the United States history. Reporter Brandy Persuti has more on this now.
African American history dates back to the 1600s, when African Americans were brought into the colonies for slave work. However, it wasn't up until the 20th century that Black history was even acknowledged. Son of former slave Dr. Carter G. Woodson brought the public eye to attention by creating the Association of Negro Life in 1915. A year later, he created the Journal of African American History. From that point on, iconic figures that we know today began filling in the pages. Woodson created Negro Week in the second week of February, in honor of Abraham Lincoln and Frederick Douglass, which would soon expand to be Black History Month. We take this month to remember and appreciate all the accomplishments and achievements of African Americans that had impacted our culture and everyday lives. From Wax News, I'm Brandy Persuti.
Clearly, Black History Month is a very important aspect of American history and culture. Thanks to Brandy for all that elaborate information. Another important aspect of the month of February is President's Day. President's Day is a federal holiday that many people don't know much about. This holiday is always on the third Monday in February. It was made an official holiday in 1885 in honor of George Washington's birthday, February 22nd. It wasn't until 1971 that the name changed to President's Day. This change occurred when it was moved to be a part of the Uniform Monday Holiday Act. This act was an attempt to establish more three-day weekends for workers across the nation.
It's so important to understand why we are given off of school for certain holidays. When we come back, we'll be learning how prom flowers are arranged and we'll be getting a behind-the-scenes look at the preparation for the Vitality Fashion Show coming up in March. We are also going to let you know what fundraisers are going on right now throughout the school. Stick with us.
Tim, we need you to find the funniest teacher.
I'm on it.
Welcome back to Wax News. The sophomore and junior classes are all currently running their annual class fundraisers. The juniors are selling Niagara chocolate bars. Popular flavors such as mint and caramel can be purchased for $1 each. The sophomores are selling cookie dough, frozen pizzas, and many other frozen treats. All items sold are $17 each. The proceeds will be going towards prom, senior night, senior trips, and other activities. Senior reporter Joe Peruzzi has his full scoop on this year's fundraisers.
Throughout the months of February and March, the sophomores and juniors hold their class fundraisers to benefit their senior class activities. The sophomores are selling frozen cookie dough from Otis Spunkmeyer. There are 12 different flavors available, as well as an assortment of other frozen foods and pastries for $17 each. Be sure to ask a sophomore to see all of the delicious options in the catalog.
The junior class is selling candy bars.
What are they selling?
Chocolates!
All sorts of different flavors candy bars for $1. They are selling them now through March 31st, which is the end of the month, for $1 a piece. You can find any junior, come see me and, you know, get a candy bar. Lots of different flavors, including tasty Sixlets.
Chocolate!
The money's going to be used for several things. It's going to help fund the prom, which helps both juniors and seniors. It's also going to be used to fund our class activities for senior year, our senior nights, our senior cafes, potential senior trips. So the money goes towards our class of 2018. We've had 80 boxes of candy go out. Yep, and we've had quite a few come back, and every day more and more come back. Kids are really selling them. I know candy bars kind of sell themselves, so I'm very, very happy with the junior class. They've been doing a really good job.
Be sure to support your classmates by purchasing cookie dough and candy bars before the end of the month.
The class fundraisers seem to be very successful this year. Be sure to continue supporting your peers by purchasing candy or cookie dough. With prom just around the corner, reporter Alyssa Weary is keeping us up to date with everything needed to make this prom a memorable one. This week, Alyssa traveled to Alden's very own Savers Florist to get an inside look on how boutonnieres and corsages are made. Savers has been providing the school with stunning bouquets for many years. Let's take a look at that now.
Spring is in the air and prom is right around the corner. The Savers Flower Shop is a popular choice here among Alden when deciding where students want to purchase their floral prom decorations, such as corsages and boutonnieres. They do any sort of flower arrangements for other events, such as birthdays, anniversaries, weddings, and many more. For prom, they carry a wide variety of flowers, colors, and ribbons, in which they combine beautifully into corsages and boutonnieres. The work here at the Savers Flower Shop is exceptional, and they are delighted to be Alden School's top pick for any floral decorations when needed. For more information, please visit their website at www.saversflowershop.com or the Wax News website or any social media pages.
Those flowers certainly are beautiful. Be sure to consider choosing Savers as your prom florist this year. As you may have heard, the Donate Life Club is bringing back a popular event this year. The Vitality Fashion Show is coming back and will be better than ever. The event is on March 25th, and students are already hard at work improving their modeling skills for the show. The Fashion Show is a fundraiser for Andrews Army and UNITS. UNITS is Western New York's only organ, eye, tissue, and blood donation center. Along with the donations from the Fashion Show, Andrews Army hosts 3 yearly blood drives here at Alden High School. Andrews Army has donated over $115,000 and over 2,000 units of blood to UNITS. Vitality 3.0 is sure to be a huge success and a great way to raise money for UNITS. Reporter Jordan Lawrence has a sneak peek of this exciting event.
The Vitality 3.0 fashion show is quickly coming up in the last weeks of March. There are many new updates that the producers would like to elaborate on. I met up with Mr. Matt Mashi to talk about the new venue for the show.
This year, we're really excited about moving the event into the auditorium. For the past couple of times, we've had it in the cafeteria. This year, having the fashion show in the auditorium means a couple things. We have a great sound system and a lighting system here. We're able to do a lot more in terms of staging because we can do it several days in advance versus doing it all the morning of and the day before and then tearing it all down the same night. We had to take a cafeteria and make it look like it was a professional venue. In here, we have a lot more seats. We have the ability to have a lot more backstage space for dressing and changing and lining people up to go out on the runway. And we have a lot more in terms of technical ability in this space as well. So I'm really excited about that. And also the great thing we have in terms of seating is we're able to use our online ticketing system. So we can sell tickets specifically by seat, and then you can print them out right at home and bring them with you and not worry about any of the ticketing stuff at the door here.
I'm joining the Units Vitality Fashion Show because I support Units and I support all the things they do.
I joined the fashion show because I did it 3 years ago and it was a really great time, and I also really wanted to support Units.
Well, I was in the fashion show freshman year, so it's really cool that it's making a comeback and that we can all participate in it again.
I did the Vitality Fashion Show because I did it when I was a freshman and it was a lot of fun, so I wanted to be part of it again.
This is the first year the fashion show was an option for me, and I'm really excited to be a part of it.
This year, the Vitality Fashion Show is going to be in the auditorium. For the past two shows that we've done, it's been in the cafeteria, so it's a totally different venue. We can hold more seats, we can sell more tickets and raise more money for Units and Andrew's Army. We're excited. It's going to be different. I mean, we have so much more space to work with. The models are going to have a ton more space in the back for backstage, longer runway, longer time to see the clothes that are up there. And this year, we are announcing that we're doing a theme. We've never done a theme for the show before. It's just kind of been a fashion show, and that was the end of it. And this year, we're doing a vintage carnival theme. So we'll have aerialist acts, we'll have, we'll bring in the lion tamer and the ringleaders and the trapeze artists and create this feel and this vibe for our audience and, you know, captivate them and bring them into our circus and bring them in for a really great show.
Vitality 3.0 is sure to be a hit. To stay updated on this exciting event, follow Vitality Fashion on Twitter and Instagram by searching Vitality Fashion 3.0. Coming up on Wax News, we'll be getting the highlights from the Athletic Association's badminton tournament. We'll also get the latest on the varsity girls basketball team and the member who is now on the all-time girls basketball leaderboard. Stick with us. Welcome back to Wax News. Alden High School's Athletic Association hosted their annual badminton tournament. Both students and teachers participated in this event on Thursday, February 16th. Attendance was excellent as many students came out to support their peers and teachers. The tournament was a nail-biter as it got down to the final championship match. Josh Tester has more on the entire event and which team was victorious. Let's take a look.
It was a dream of mine. Last year we fell a little short on the badminton. Really broke my heart. This year we practiced over the summer, Mr. Casillo and myself, and we really wanted to come back and win it this year. It meant a lot to both of us. I mean, taking that trophy home was big. So we set out to do it, and that's exactly what we did. We brought home the championship. Oh, I think some of my obstacles, there were some tough teams this year. I think some of the obstacles were Nate Rieger and Pelletieri. They were a tough team to get by. But I think the final match, the toughest team was Tom Benarski and Brian Cebulski. They put together a great team. They complemented each other pretty well, and they fought hard. They were beating us in both games, but we put together a tight game. We came back and served well and got them moving around, and you know what? We overcame that obstacle. Mr. Casillo and I prepared hard, did a lot of training in the summer. Down on the beach, we did a lot of beach running. We did a lot of hiking in the mountains. Did a lot of volleying back and forth, working on our backhand and our smashes and our drops. I think we put the time in to get that championship this year. I'd like to thank the Alden Athletic Association for allowing this tournament to go on. We try to do this every year to raise some dollars for scholars, and I think it's a great way to raise money. I'd like to put a big thanks to the new phys ed teacher, Ian, and Paul Casillo, great job putting on the tournament. And I gotta thank Paul Casillo for covering me. Took an old man and he made me look young again. Thanks, Paulie.
It certainly seems like the badminton tournament was a huge success. Congratulations again to the winners and all who participated in this thrilling event. Keeping with the discussion of sports, girls basketball